I train for the streets. The streets are more dangerous than the cage.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Fight Bible. On today's video, we're going to be answering the age-old question which has been floating around in the YouTubeverse for quite a while and has recently been answered in a video by IcyMike.
Never go to the ground in a street fight. All fights go to the ground. And it might seem like there's some logic to both of those statements, which is how these myths get propagated.
Does every fight end up on the ground? But we think that every single fight, that's right, every single fight will end up on the ground.
Eventually. There's
the
key
word.
Points in this, yes?
Eventually.
If I don't count someone coming up and going...
Yeah, that's not a
fight. That's not a fight.
That's not a fight. No. Given enough time and nobody interfering, every single fight will end up on the ground. People always say, in a street fight, there's no rules. We would argue that people are more courteous in street fights than they are in the cage. But a referee will stop them. Yes, a referee will stop them. How many times in a street fight have you seen someone get knocked out and then deliver four or five perfect hammer fists to a downed opponent and then get up and walk away?
Well, usually, that's because you don't see it because it doesn't make
doesn't
YouTube.
Happen exactly.
Doesn't
well, make
YouTube well. Anyway, yeah.
But also, someone gets hit, knocked out, and then their friends bum rush them, and fight's over.
Two.
Die!
Oh my god!
Just maybe.
But technically, the fight did go to the ground because the guy's dead on the floor. If he wanted to, he could jump on top of them and pound the fuck out of them. But he didn't.
So you've got to stop doing. That's the bit we're addressing, right? Is that if you both stand up, even if you neither of us want to go to the ground, I clip you, you're now on the ground.
From a competition basis.
I can follow you down.
Yeah.
Should you follow him down? Yeah, I suppose.
If you want to.
It's up to you.
Is it again? If there's no rules, no ramifications of murdering someone, the fight will always.
If it was a fight till death, it will always go to the ground.
Always go to the ground. End of. That is literally the game.
Unless you want to hold a map for the rest of his life.
No, exactly.
For the rest of his life.
Walk around with him like a sock puppet.
He's got to hold him there, you've got to hold him. You're not having to go over the floor yourself because you still typically fight him. Because he'll end up on the floor.
Yeah. So the argument of will it go to the ground? Absolutely. Obviously, there are lots of variations to this. Mike mentioned anti-grappling and how anti-grappling doesn't exist. Anti-grappling is essentially grappling.
But these statements don't really stand up to the most basic level of scrutiny or logic.
So the main proponent for a fight always goes to the ground is usually jiu-jitsu guys and wrestlers because that's where they're best versed. They will take their fight to the ground. Someone who does taekwondo, for instance, will say, oh, I'll just kick them. Because that's what they're versed in. Someone who does boxing, I'll punch him in the face. But guess what? A street fight isn't a rule set. You can't choose what you choose to do. You can maybe choose, but if the other guy has a different idea and he's better than you, you're kind of playing by his rules. And if you're a boxer and he chooses to take you down, you're going to the ground. Simple as that. But the idea that every fight ends on the ground is true. The idea that all fights go to the ground, given enough time, absolutely.
All fights going to the ground is just an untrue statement because we have plenty of videos of fights that don't.
Hadouken! Given someone's proclivity to want to go to the ground, it will go to the ground. If you've got 10 people all trying to pull you off of each other, it ain't gonna go to the ground because that's not a life or death style fight.
You're the crab baby!
In the MMA, guy gets knocked out, you go to the ground. Yes, a referee will stop it, but that's part of the rule set. That's called keeping someone alive. If the ref just went, I see no problem with you hammer fisting the guy's face until he dies, are you gonna stop?
Come on.
за все. Пассивная защита. Почему?
Это что такое?
Ну, видимо, что-то личное сделал очень плохое Денису Сиропляцу. Майкель Фалькао. Бразилец, ну, потрясен, конечно, избит.
Вы посмотрите.
Но, опять же, да, еще одна серия ударов, несколько тяжелых попаданий, и вновь Тиле. Требует уже, наверное, в десятый раз рефери.
That fight ended there. Do you remember watching the film Gladiator? Remember Gladiator?
Yeah.
Raffle, crap, that. All of those fights really ended up on the ground because as soon as they slashed him, he dropped. What was it, the thumb up, the bum, or thumb down,
exactly.
The bum?
There's a guy on the floor.
On the floor, yeah. But
exactly.
We know where Mike was coming from. We're not picking on Mike. We're just saying, I knew what he meant when he said it. Like, not all of the fights you see, but they're not all, but if they were actual fights till death, that they would all go to the ground. Street fight, I've seen street fights not go to the ground, but if they were left to keep fighting, they would have. That's the only difference. I know exactly what Mike was saying, but we had to, because we get so many comments, Mike, as well, we had to address it, because we get so many cock smokers on air saying that fights don't go to the ground, or fights only go to the ground when I choose it to.
If you aren't willing to go to the ground, you'll never fully end your fight. So, those people were like, I train for the streets are more dangerous than a cage. It's like, but unless you train the ground stuff, you'll never be able to do what you claim to be able to do. Obviously, a jiu-jitsu guy will just be able to drag you to the ground, grab hold of something and torque it, break it, snap it, choke you out, put you to sleep, kill you.
I mean,
do whatever the hell he wants.
Fighting.
Because that's where he fights.
It's very similar to shagging. Like, you can shag stand up, but it's easy to finish when you're on the ground.
It's easier.
Easier to finish.
If Brad chooses to take me down and I stuff his attack, and then work around him and get advantage somehow, that's grappling. I just did it better than my opponent. It's not anti-grappling, as Mike did definitely point out, so well done, Mike, for clearing that one up. But will for every fight end in the ground? We think it will. Here's a couple of examples of how street fights end up looking. So there you go, guys. We hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like it and subscribe to the channel. Make sure you check out all of our past catalog. There's lots of cool, fun stuff in there as well. But from today, from me, Joe, and Brad, we are out. Cheers.
Adios.